All right, so let's learn another tag. This one is the image tag. It looks like this, IMG, and this is for including images. It has the following structure. The opening IMG tag, it has an attribute called source, src equals, and this equals a URL. This is the URL of the image to download. Remember, we talked about how the web service can serve all sorts of different types of content. If you're going to serve an image, this is how you would do it. You would include it in an image tag in HTML, and you reference the URL. And then there's another attribute called alt, which stands for alternate, and this is text that gets displayed when the image doesn't load. It's required in the sense that HTML parsers will complain at you if it's not there. Nothing will break, but it's really nice to include it. For broken requests, like if our browser requests a URL that doesn't exist, this is the text that gets displayed. And it's also for blind people. It doesn't take much to add an alt text, and it'll make somebody's life or somebody's day at least mildly easier. And one other thing I'd like to point out here is every tag we've talked about so far has had a closing tag. Images don't. This is the entire tag. There's no contents to an image. See? It just ends right here. This is called a void tag. And a void tag is a tag that has no content. And because it has no content, it doesn't need a closing tag. Let's try this thing out in the browser and see how it looks in real life. Okay, so here we are in our little HTML previewer. Let's add an image. Okay, so we've got our image tag, source equals udacity.com and hipmunk.png. This is our URL of an image that I've prepared for us. We've got some alt text there. Let's go ahead and click update. And ta-da, there's our image. Now, a couple other things we can do. I could put some text here. There's our text. Images just appear in line with text. Yeah, so a small image just appears right in the middle of other text.